On February 20th, Russian President Vladimir Putin officially revealed the ZIRCON hypersonic cruise missile. It's been in development since 2011. This comes at a time when tensions between the U.S. and Russia has increased many folds due to the U.S. decision to withdraw from the INF Treaty, blaming Russia for non-compliance. Please refer to the video on the above card to know the details of the INF Treaty or Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty. Russia One TV channel has now listed possible U.S. assets that could be targeted by ZIRCON. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why ZIRCON hypersonic cruise missile could be unstoppable. Let's get into the details. As per President Putin's address in the Russian Federal Assembly, the ZIRCON is capable of reaching speeds of Mach 9. So it's much faster than a bullet fired from a sniper rifle, actually almost three times the speed of a sniper's bullet. The kinetic energy alone will rip a ship apart like a tin can. Mr. Putin stated that the missile has a range of over 1,000 kilometers or 620 miles. It's interesting to note that the speed as well as the range is significantly higher than the earlier reports, which stated these to be Mach 6 and 500 kilometers respectively. ZIRCON is equipped with a scramjet engine type, which compresses air before it enters the combustion chamber. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet, in which the combustion chamber is specially designed to operate the supersonic airflow. Ramjet engine powers the Indo-Russian BrahMos supersonic cruise missile that can travel at speeds of 2.8 to 3 Mach. Scramjet is simply an acronym for Supersonic Combustion Ramjet. The missile weighs 5 tons. President Putin mentioned that the missile is able to destroy both seagoing and land targets. As per reports, the ZIRCON will have both radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to detect and track targets. The missile could be equipped with a high explosive warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead. According to Mr. Putin, the ZIRCON is mainly intended to be deployed in seagoing platforms, such as serially made surface warships and submarines, including those that are already operational and being built. Admiral Nakhimov, the Russian-powered Kirov-class Project 1144 battlecruiser, and its sister ship, Peter Veliki, will be the first warships to have this missile. As for submarines, Russia's existing fleet of conventional and nuclear submarines, like the Project 855M Yasin-class and the upcoming Husky-class submarines, will have the missile integrated. It's to be noted that there are many reports in Russian media that indicate that a lighter air launch variant is also under development. The variant could be deployed with two 160M2 Blackjack and will complement the Kinzhal hypersonic missile intended for deployment in the MiG-31B heavyweight multi-role fighters. The combination of these multiple launch platforms with hypersonic cruise missiles makes it a versatile weapon. According to the Russian state-run Russia One TV channel, ZIRCON will be used against these targets in case of war. 1. The Pentagon, the headquarters of the United States Department of Defense. 2. Camp David, officially known as the Naval Support Facility Thurmont, the country retreat for the President of the U.S. 3. Fort Ritchie, Maryland, alternate high command post for the U.S. President and a command center of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. 4. McClellan Air Force Base, California, headquarters of the Strategic Offensive Forces. Viewers may note that these targets are all high-value targets and are being listed since hitting them could impede America's decision-making and ability to respond. The most important aspect of ZIRCON is its speed. The speed would give air defenses very little time to detect and fire interceptors. Current air defense systems can defend against subsonic missiles reliably and are effective against supersonic missiles to an extent, but against hypersonic missiles, they will fail. It is to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report has stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. Viewers can go through the report from the link given in the description section below. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. Another important aspect of the missile is its plasma cloud. As per multiple reports, the missile is completely covered by plasma cloud during the flight. The plasma cloud would absorb radio frequencies emitted from radars, and since the waves are not reflected back, it will essentially mean that the missile will be invisible. It's highly likely that the missile will be detected very late, and this will make intercepting ZIRCON even more difficult.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.